about 3 hours into my drive down here. I'm on I-5. This is the same route I took when I moved back up to Oakland. Well, it's Saturday morning. I think it's already like 85 degrees. Because there's no coffee pot, so I've had no coffee this morning. I think the plan will be to get gas, maybe get some energy drink or something over at the gas station, and then kind of head out for the day. The shower was kind of interesting. If you turn on the water and do that, it doesn't really work. It kind of dribbles out. So I had to take a shower, and that last night with the water dribbling out like that. And then the sink, you turn to the right, for some reason the hot water's on the right. This is hot water coming out here. You turn to the left, this is the cold water, but it barely comes out. I think the top's all messed up too. I don't know if you can see that. Okay, I'm ready to go see how hot it is outside. Let's do it. It's not too bad so far. Might be where the swimming pool used to be. Wow, look at all those windmills. Oh, this looks much different in the daytime than it did when I got here last night and I couldn't see anything. This is Mohave, full of trains, windmills, gas stations, and there's the Denny's I ate at last night, if you can see it coming up. Well, I've pulled off the highway here, got my energy drink. I'm gonna try and check out this little town over here. I guess someone used to live here, right? Is this a residence just on the side of the road? Open these coolers up and see what's inside. Put myself in this broken glass either. I wanted to come poke around. It's on the other side. This hill. How the heck can I get to that? Is that all empty in there? Can you see inside? I guess so. This poor car has been demolished. Oh dear. No bee's nest in there? Okay, good. Okay, how do I get over to this thing? Well, there she is. And here we are. The SS Minnow. Well, that sounds familiar. Let me see in there. Probably not much. Right? An only 3 hour tour? I don't know. That wasn't the best TV show. I think the Harlem Globetrotters went over to Gilligan's Island. It was kind of where it jumped the shark. Okay.
I think that's it for this place. It's just kind of a little dilapidated area.
Alright, one more drink of this. We're on to the next one.
What's this?
Some kind of ball.
It's too small to be a soccer ball, so I'm not sure what it is.
Just miles and miles of nothing. I suppose I get close to my exit. Maybe we'll see Lancaster, California pretty soon.
This church here supposedly is the church where they filmed Kill Bill, parts 1 and 2. It says film here. I wonder if I can go inside. Let's check it out and see. Is it open? Oh no, it's not open. Can see inside, they probably have it all blocked off. It says film here. Huh. The Sanctuary Church. Saturday is at 9:30. Service at 11:30. It says I can film here too if I all that number, but I look around, there's not much inside here. Not for sale. Never mind, I think. This is someone's private property. Okay. Well, there's not too much to see here. I think this place actively holds services. That's what that sign said. Over on the front. I can barely read that. Escuela Sunday School. Okay. Off to the next place? We'll see. We'll see if I... check this out. So the tour guide we just saw was telling me they filmed a lot of movies here, and apparently a Cardi B video, which was not to his liking because it was raunchy. But yeah, you can definitely tell Kill Bill was filmed here. I got that. They have like a repurposed door. Some cool windows and these old seats and everything. Now, this is interesting. This is definitely older than me. Gosh. And so much history here.
And this is the katana they use for the movie.
Is it a real one then?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh.
Well, it's a prop.
Yeah.
It doesn't have, it's not sharp.
Oh, okay.
They use it for the movie.
Okay, I see.
And in the movie, they make sure they don't have bullets.
Yeah.
Or sharp things.
That was a violent scene. Gosh, I remember that. That movie's 20 years old, I think.
Yeah.
Which makes me feel old.
It was, that movie was filmed in 2002.
Okay.
Because 2003, I bought the building.
Were you here then when they filmed the movie?
No. I was living here because I've been here 37 years in this desert.
Wow. Okay.
But buying the church, I bought it in 2003.
Did you see them then when you were?
Oh, yes.
You came and saw them and... Yeah. How long were they here for?
They were like 1 week.
Oh, okay. I've never been in a film set, so I have no idea how long.
It's fun.
Is that interesting? I imagine it's a lot of sitting around, and kind of waiting to shoot your scene. That's kind of what I imagine it is.
Cardi B.
Yeah.
I played the role of a father.
Yeah.
And another two, I'm a cowboy.
I'll see you.
And another one, I'm a borderline control.
Are you in the credits then for some of these movies?
And another one, I'm a gang member.
Wow. So, very interesting.
Yeah.
Got a lot of history in there. Oh, cool.
How they do it, very interested too.
Yeah.
And that's why I lost the taste of the movies now.
Mm-hmm.
Because I know how they made it.
Oh, you can kind of see behind the scenes, and when you watch a movie and figure out the way they shot everything. All right. On to the next great adventure, which I think will be lunch. It's the views I'm seeing here in the desert. It's kind of little tiny homes. I wonder what we like to live out here. I'd be at that liquor store all the time, I'll tell you that. More dilapidated shit to look at. This thing is just full of garbage. They got air, little kids' plaything. This just looks like a dump for stuff. I wonder what this was. Something at one point. Some kid's textbook. It's only 102 degrees. That's what I bought. This little thing of water. I think that'll get me through it. What is this called? Dead Man something. Dead Man's Rocks? Dead Man's Curves? I imagine the locals would come here on the weekends. Draw big blue dicks on the wall. Fuck the dumb shit. That's what I say. Fuck the dumb shit. There's a lot of it. Is there anything in here besides snakes and wind? Dead end over here. Cups rattling in the wind. Very apocalyptic. Let this person go. Some pizza maybe? Some Taco Bell? Okay, I think I end this video here. So see you next time, my journey in the Mohave Desert over my July 4th weekend continues. It'll be this hot, 102 degrees or so, the entire time. But I've handled it so far. I'm sure I can keep going. Alright, I'll see you later.